There have been more than 100 car break-ins in Kill Devil Hills since August.
Tonight, a teenager is in custody in connection with at least 10 of them. Police believe there are other suspects out there, but this is just the first step in solving a troubling epidemic.
Robert Boyd has the story tonight from the Outer Banks.
Well, police say 90% of these car break-ins happened because the victims simply failed to lock their doors. So even though an arrest has been made, people still have to use common sense.
Deborah Voss says it's been nerve-wracking parking your car in Kill Devil Hills, not knowing if your belongings will still be there when you return.
And especially with the holidays coming up, there's a lot of people that are going to be shopping.
After more than 100 break-ins since August, police have now made a break in the case. On Thursday, 17-year-old Sky Bland of Collington was arrested and charged with 10 counts of breaking and entering of a motor vehicle and 8 counts of theft.
How glad are you at least someone's been arrested?
Very much so. It makes me feel a little bit more secure when coming out here in the evenings, especially by myself.
Cheryl Hasty has had her car broken into 6 times.
They went through all my glove compartment. They took anything that was metal out of my car that was of value to them.
Cheryl, like many of these victims, made one huge mistake. She didn't lock her door.
I'm trustworthy. I even sometimes leave my key in the ignition, you know, if I'm just running into the store.
Don Cooper is an insurance agent. He deals with these head-scratching issues every day.
We have people call in and say, I got broken into. I said, well when you're broken? No, my car was unlocked. I go, well, you lock your car.
What's most alarming to residents? More than 10 firearms were stolen from inside these vehicles during this rash of break-ins.
I mean, you don't know where that gun's going. I mean, in other words, you've got a handgun that you left in your unlocked car that's either going to be sold to who knows whoever or used for whatever. And ultimately, you know, that's your handgun. That's your responsibility.
Police did not confirm if Bland was in possession of any stolen handguns. He is being held on $140,000 bond. Police are also working to arrest a friend of Bland's on similar charges. In Kill Devil Hills, Robert Boyd, 13 News Now.